From 2023, Switzerland will adopt the EU drone regulation. In this video, you will learn all the important things to consider in order to be allowed to fly a drone in Switzerland. The European drone laws apply to all member states of the European Union, as well as the United Kingdom and all the members of EASA, Switzerland, Iceland, Norway and Liechtenstein. The new drone regulation introduces different clauses for drones and divides the purpose of flights into different categories. This includes the open category, the special category and the certified category. Open category. Low-risk flights fall into the open category. There's no need to obtain a permit for such flights. Most flights are in the open category. The open category is divided into three subcategories, A1, A2 and A3. To be able to fly in the open category, the following conditions must be met. You have registered yourself as a drone pilot on the UAS.gate, unless the drone weighs less than 250 grams and has neither a camera nor other sensors with which personal data can be recorded. You have successfully completed the proper training with examination of the corresponding subcategory. You are older than 12 years. If not, you must be accompanied by a person older than 16 who has the necessary knowledge themselves. You shall not fly over crowds and the minimum distance will be kept, according to the subcategory A1, A2 and A3. The maximum flight altitude of 120 meters above ground is not exceeded. To fly higher, a permit from the BATSL is required. The drone must have a class marking C0, C1, C2, C3 or C4 and have a CE mark. For all the drones, apply transitional provisions. Area restrictions will be respected too. Flights take place within visual range. FPV pilots need an observer who can see the drone. You are sufficiently insured. Subcategory A1. Subcategory A1 includes all drones that weigh less than 900 grams. This includes the classes C0 and C1. For drones lighter than 250 grams, no training is required. However, the pilot and the drone must be registered and the UAS operator number must be displayed on the drone. Flying over crowds is prohibited with these drones and flying over other people should be avoided. Drones weighing between 250 and 900 grams also belong to the subcategory A1, but to fly these drones the A1/A3 certificate is mandatory. The pilot must also be registered and have completed a training including examination. Flying over crowds of people is prohibited. The pilot must assess the situation himself to ensure that no uninvolved persons are flown over. Subcategory A2. Drones that are lighter than 4 kg and have the class C2 belong to the subcategory A2. In order to fly a drone from this subcategory, the pilot must have successfully completed the training and the A1/A3 and A2 test. More detailed information is available at this internet address. All the links that are shown on the screen in this video will be in the video description. For pilots of the subcategory A2, the 1-to-1 rule applies to uninvolved persons. This means that at an altitude of 40 meters, a horizontal distance of minimum 40 meters must be maintained. The minimum horizontal distance is 30 meters. In low speed mode, that is less than 3 meters per second, a minimum horizontal distance of 5 meters must be maintained. Subcategory A3. This subcategory includes all drones of classes C2, C3 or C4 and weighing less than 25 kg. In order to fly drones in this category, the A1/A3 training and test must be successfully completed. The minimum horizontal distance to uninvolved persons is 30 meters. Flying is only allowed outside urban areas. A minimum horizontal distance of 150 meters must be maintained from residential, commercial, industrial and recreational areas. Special category. If the drone has a takeoff weight of more than 25 kilograms or cannot comply with the applicable rules of the open category, drone operation must be authorized. The Batzel now issues all operating licenses only in accordance with the EU law. There are four licensing procedures, which will be now explained in brief. For more detailed information, visit the official page from the Batzel. Standard scenarios. There are two types of standard scenarios: the European Standard Scenario (EU-STS) and the National Standard Scenario (CHSTS). Here you will find the most important reference points. The Swiss Standard Scenario will still be issued until the end of 2023. From 2024, there will be only the EU-STS. The European Standard Scenario prescribes a class marking, which is however not required in the CHSTS. The authorization is valid for 2 years. The Swiss CHSTS is only valid in Switzerland, whereas the EU-STS is valid both in Switzerland and in the European Union. The following requirements must be met in order to obtain a permit. The cost for such certificates vary depending on the type of STS. The proceeding time for an EU-STS is 2 weeks. For an CHSTS, the waiting time depends on the respective CHSTS type. Predefined risk assessment. In PDRA, unlike STS, no specific scenarios are specified and the drone does not necessarily have to have a class marking. This gives operators more flexibility in conducting the drone flight. However, the application for a PDRA is considered confirmation that he or she meets all the specified conditions. In the PDRA authorization process, there are two types: PDRA-S and PDRA-G. Specific operations risk assessment. For drone flights for which the STS or PDRA are not sufficient, there is the SORA. Here the authorization is precisely adapted to the operation. This means, for example, that flights beyond visual range or above the maximum flight altitude are also possible. The application, which contains a detailed description of the operation, identifies the potential risk. This application also includes measures to minimize the risk so that no people or objects in the air or on the ground are endangered. As the risk analysis is carried out by the applicant, knowledge of aviation is required, as well as the usual aviation verification tests to check safety-relevant systems. Light UAS Operator Certificate. The Batzel issues LUC certificates to professional operators or to manufacturers of drones. The LUC certificate enables the operator to carry out precisely defined processes themselves, for which the Batzel would normally be responsible. Category subject to registration. Model aircraft with a high risk are assigned to category requiring approval. The Batzel decides on the approval depending on the case. In Switzerland and Europe, however, no drones requiring approval have been operated to date. Precise rules and therefore be still being prepared as of publication of this video. Classes. The manufacturers of drones are responsible for ensuring that their products are given the appropriate class designations. This way, drone pilots don't have to struggle with the technical details. The higher the class number, the higher the risk of endangering someone. In this table, you can see the most important specifications for the classifications into the different classes. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any questions about the drone laws in Switzerland, feel free to post them in the comments. Like and share the video if you enjoy my work, and check out Schweizer Drohnen for amazing videography in Switzerland.